Hello, my lovely former grade 4 students. Okay, so right now you're in grade 5, so you're former grade 4. Okay, so I welcome you to grade 5 and I'll welcome you back to Creative Arts once again. You know my name already, I'm Auntie Mavis. Okay, so we are going to three topics under creative arts, under visual arts and performing arts. Okay, so our first lesson is going to be about Cherish Samba. Okay, he's a visual artist, a very popularly known visual artist all over Africa. Okay, so we are going to do a short introduction to some Ghanaian and African visual artists that will tackle all of them throughout grade 5. Okay, so I'm going to introduce them to you. We are going to learn a brief history about Cherry Samba. Okay, and we're also going to learn about his artworks and how his artworks were influenced by the environment and the cultural practices around him and his people. Okay, so as usual, after this lesson, you're going to have a short test and make sure you score all the marks for me. Okay, so let's quickly move to our first slide and start our lesson. Great class, so we are going to learn about artists, okay, visual artists and performing artists. So we are going to learn how these people are able to come out skillfully through their art and communicate to us, the audience, as we watch their art, what we are able to derive from them, how we are able to identify that this particular art is an African art or is a Ghanaian art, how they are able to influence the society and the world at large. Okay, so artists always communicate their feelings and their ideas and their style through what? Art. Okay, so we are going to learn about some of these visual artists, as I said earlier. So art can represent a lot of ways in which people express their personal identity. For instance, contemporary Ghanaian artists use their artistic traditions and experiences to comment on identity, society, and the world at large. Okay, so they use their ideas, okay, and their traditions within their environment and their surroundings. For instance, those in Ghana will use the traditions and the culture of Ghana and portray it in their art. So once you see this kind of art, you realize that this kind of art was made by a Ghanaian or was made by an African. So contemporary artist simply means an artist who makes artwork about issues that are happening currently, not in the past, current issues. Okay, so art of today, in other words, is known as what? Contemporary art. Okay, so artists use these forms to express their ideas and their feelings to the society through their identity to the world at large. Okay, so art can be a record of human experiences in style, like I said, differences in style and among different artists can be associated with a specific reason, intent, or motivation. Okay, for instance, this pandemic that happened will motivate an artist to bring out a very nice art piece, a painting, or anything that will just communicate the feeling or the impact of the coronavirus in Ghana, in Africa, or the world at large. Okay, so there are many visual artists in Ghana and Africa who have been recognized internationally because of their great works. For your work to be recognized internationally, most of the time you need to do something unique, something that people will look at it and would want to look at it further and further. Okay, so that's what mostly happens. And some of these visual artists include El Enatu, Cherry Samba, Nena Okore, Gonkala Mbanda, Abdoulaye Konate, and there are many others. But as I said earlier, in this lesson, you're going to learn about who? Cherry Samba. Okay, so let's quickly move to our next slide and re-learn a brief history about Cherry Samba. Okay, great class. So, who is Cherry Samba? You can see his handsome picture nicely placed there. Okay, so if you don't know Cherry Samba, this is Cherry Samba for you. So now let's look at a brief history of this nice gentleman. So Cherry Samba was born on 30th December 1956. He is a painter from the Democratic Republic of Congo who is currently living and working at Kinshasa, the capital city of Congo. He is one of the famous contemporary artists in Africa, and he began his career as an artist without any formal education, starting out as a sign painter with his younger brother, Cheick Lady. Okay, so Cherry Samba didn't have any formal education like you and I are going through now. He started like as a sign writer. He gets some plywood, paints the background white, and then whatever you post that you want him to write, if you want him to write for sale, if you want to want him to write eggs are sold here, if you want him to write anything, he draws them nicely and then come and paste it in front of your shop or something. So that's what he started with. So as an artist, you can start gradually from any level that you are. Okay, so he started this from a very poor background, and eventually he has become one of the most popular contemporary artists in Africa. Okay, so art is not limited to anything. Once you have the desire, you can do great things with your art skills. Okay, so Cherry Samba's artworks have been included in the collections of the Central Georges Pompidou in Paris and the Museum of Modern Art in New York. So the Central Georges Pompidou, they collect a lot of artworks and a lot of stuff and then place it there. So if yours is there, it is an honor for your artwork to be at such a place. And then the Museum of Modern Art in New York. Okay, the name New York alone tells you the level that it carries. Okay, so through he becoming, starting from a very poor background, now look at where some of his artworks have been displayed. Okay, let's quickly move to the next slide and continue with his history. Wonderful class. So we are still on the brief history of Cherry Samba. Okay, so let's quickly go on. So Samba is known for his signature brand of painting, mixing photorealism, comic book caricature, and text into one hybrid style, which he addresses the condition of being a contemporary Congolese artist. Okay, so his artwork is made up of all these things. His artwork is made up of what? Painting, mixing photorealism, we will define photorealism down there, comic books, caricature. Okay, caricature is simply exaggerated images, and the text into one hybrid style, with which he addresses the condition of being a contemporary Congolese artist. So he portrays mostly Congolese culture and the lifestyle of Congolese in his artists by mixing all these kind of arts together. So let's look at what photorealism is. Photorealism is a genre of art that includes painting, drawing, and other graphic media in which an artist studies a photograph and then attempts to produce the image as realistically as possible in another standard. Okay, so let's say you take a picture of yourself and you want to draw and paint that picture to look exactly like you. Okay, that is the way you are doing photorealism. You want to make that picture, paint that picture, or draw that picture to look exactly like you, probably add some colors or add some other design to make it in a unique way just for it to look like you. So you are using different media to do the work in your standard. Okay, so that's just photorealism. Okay, then we have contemporary art. What is contemporary art? Contemporary art is the art made today by living artists. As such, it reflects the complex issues that shape our diverse, global, and rapidly changing world. Okay, so contemporary artists make art of today, things that are happening around us currently. Okay, and most of those artists are alive. Okay, so these are some of the brief artworks that Cherry Samba mostly engages in, the kind of things he put together to come out with his beautiful artworks. Okay, and this is a brief history of Cherry Samba, the things he needs or he puts together to bring out such nice piece of artwork that causes people to imagine how come he came about those ideas to make those beautiful art pieces. So now let's go and look at some of his artworks and look at how he portrayed them, how he portrayed himself, and how he was able to establish his own style through his own artistic ideas. Okay, all right, let's go to the next slide. Awesome. So there's one example of Cherry Samba's paintings. Okay, you can see his beautiful image there, and you can see some maps around him. When you look at this critically, you wonder what exactly is this man trying to portray. But when you turn it upside down, you realize that he is trying to create, or he has created, the world map and he has fixed himself in it. Okay, you can see African map there, you can see Australia there, you can see Europe, you can see North and South America, and you can see Antarctica, as well as what Asia, but he has merged them together. So if you are not critical enough, you will not realize that he has turned the world map upside down and he has drawn his image to fit there. So his artworks always appeal to our conscience. You will look at the artwork and you wonder, what is this man trying to portray? That is his artistic idea, his way of portraying his artwork to confuse you, to portray to your conscience, to think critically about his artwork. Okay, so most of the time, most of his artworks are not titled. Okay, so let's quickly move to the next slide and look at another piece of his artworks. Great, so look at these images too. Okay, I'm sure you're wondering, what kind of human being has these divisions all over his body? Okay, that's Cherry Samba for you. He's trying to appeal to your conscience, to think about what this art actually means. So you can see from the left side of the art, the one he's standing beside the artwork, you can see a human portrait that has been drawn. That's from his head to his chest. It has been divided like you are peeling an orange. That has been divided in a quill shape form. Okay, and he has this firm paintbrush in his mouth that is dripping from the tip of the brush different colors. Okay, you can see red, you can see yellow, you can see green, and the other tip of the brush is having a flower fixed on it firmly. So you'll be wondering, how come this divided person has this brush firmly in his mouth? Well, that is his way of appealing to your conscience, for you to think about what he's trying to communicate to you. Think about a lot of things. Okay, so that's Cherry Samba for you. He will appeal to your conscience with his artwork. Now let's look at the image on our right side. Okay, you can see three images there. Okay, they all have the same look but different colors. Okay, we can see two white images and one black image. The first image is also divided likewise, and then he has opened his mouth with his tongue sticking out. What is he trying to bring out? The second one looks like something is coming out of his mouth. Then the third image has a world map on his tongue. Guess what he's trying to tell us? That probably the world is made up of human beings, and human beings, whatever we are made up of, whatever we do in this world, we speak words. Okay, so our words make up the world, or whatever we say makes great impact in the world. Okay, so he appeals to your conscience with his artworks, and it's so marvelous to think about them. Okay, all right, so let's quickly move to our next slide and find out what really influenced this man's artwork, whether it is his environmental or cultural activities, how it affected his artworks. Let's go to the next slide and find out. Wonderful. I hope you are enjoying our lesson on Cherry Samba. So let's look at the environmental and cultural influences on Cherry Samba's paintings. The first one is, some of his paintings expose the everyday life of the people of the Democratic Republic of Congo's capital city, Kinshasa. We read from the beginning that that is where he's currently living. So most of his artworks depict the lifestyle of the Congolese, especially in where? Kinshasa. Okay, so the second point is, he started portraying himself frequently and literally in his paintings, taking on a direct role as the reporter of his ideas and personal story. So if you can see from most of his artwork, these are just a few artworks that we saw, most of his artworks, he portrays himself, his own image there, and he becomes somebody like a reporter that is bringing out the ideas or whatever idea or story that he wants to carry across through his paintings or through his artwork. He becomes the person that portrays himself as the reporter. Okay, so the third point is, Cherry Samba's paintings usually appeals to people's conscience. Remember the images that we saw earlier, they appeal to your conscience to think about, what is this man really trying to create, or what is this man really trying to say? So he appeals to people's conscience, which makes them think a lot about his artworks. So he made a statement, I appeal to people's conscience. He says, artists must make people think. So your artwork, when somebody is looking at your artwork, the person must be able to think and think deeply about the colors, about the composition of your artwork, and be able to find out, or probably think a lot about what is this artist trying to portray. So you have to be very creative when you want to do an artwork. Okay, and the fourth point is his representational fantastic paintings incorporate graphic narrative and figures with text and word bubbles that addresses political and social issues, including AIDS, social inequity and corruption. So as I said earlier on, most artists use their skills to communicate their feelings about what is happening in our society, in our country, or in the world at large. Okay, so most of his pictures, some of his artworks, like the one with the world map like this, can just tell us about social inequality, how blacks and whites, they still don't see themselves equal to each other, the corruption that is going on in government setups in countries, the HIV AIDS that is killing people. And if coronavirus were there, I'm sure by now he has even portrayed an artwork about coronavirus. So these are some of the environmental and cultural influences on Jerry Samba's artworks, or most of the time his paintings. Okay, I hope you enjoyed our lesson today. I did. I hope you also did as well. God willing, next week we are going to do an artwork just like Jerry Samba. We are going to do a painting of our portrait. So make sure you take a very nice picture and put it down for me next week. I'll show you what to do. Then we'll do a very nice picture of ourselves. Okay, take good care of yourself and be safe. Bye-bye.